So dishwashing is actually really, and it's also important for health reasons. Because one of the problems on a cruise ship is you've got a lot of people there. So the health implications of people getting, you have to be very clean. Because if 3,000 people get sick, it's not great. Okay, so this is some of the more prep. You sort of get the idea of the anybody know what Chef is doing here? It is hard to see from that picture. He's actually making sugar sculptures. So this is they're making a really big cake. That's what this is. That's a cake back there. And so he's got the silicon mat, and he's making using liquid sugar to make designs. And this is why we like cruise ships. Yes, those are cakes. This is the Colton kitchen where they're doing the prep for salads and things like that. This is, as I said, there's a few waiters. This is the breakfast service. There's still a few waiters in there. On a big ship like this, you actually have an onboard butcher and assistant butcher, because a lot of there's a lot of meat consumed. One of the things for guests, food is very important on a cruise ship, because that's what guests expect. Basically, guests will eat from the first time when they wake up to when they go to bed, and there's multiple meals throughout the day. One of the important jobs of the executive chef is actually to plan ahead, because when you're on a ship, if you're on a ship in the middle of the ocean, can you go to the shops? Oops, we're out of milk. So one of the things, this is pretty important for food production people, anybody want to guess how far in advance chef has to order the food? 2 months, 3 months, 6 months. What do you think? It's actually 6 months to a year in advance. That's how early they order the food for specific groups. So one of the big parts of planning for mid-chef is trying to figure out who will be on our cruise in 6 months, and what food do they want? Do they want steak or do they want lobster? It is actually the logistics of the ship, because again, you can't stop the ship and go to the grocery store. So you need to be able to plan in advance. And that's not just based on, obviously the heat, what past groups do, but different countries like different types of food. So it's a difficult planning. Okay, so I just mentioned that usually cruises reprovision every 7 to 14 days, depends on what their cruise is. So, if you think about it, how much space does food for 3,000 people for 12 days take? Much, exactly. That's a specific job. There's several people who work in the storage. This is the refrigerator, okay? This is the cold storage. This is the cruise ship's refrigerator. And this gentleman is the manager for that. It's not that full, because the next day they're going to be in Singapore and they're going to be reprovisioning. But at the beginning of the cruise, all of that space would have been completely full. Okay, so I mentioned the different restaurants. Most of the big that's where they get a lot. They have a lot of celebrity chefs now have celebrity restaurants. The chef's not actually on the ship, but celebrity branded restaurants on different cruise lines, and people pay. They have to pay extra to eat there. So that's all the upsell. People like sweet things. So you got the cafe where you can get tea, coffee, and muffins and stuff like that, sandwiches all day. And there was also an ice cream, soft serve ice cream. Food production people just woke up. So in addition to the dining room, most cruise ships have always had a buffet restaurant. In some cases, that's usually where people love to eat lunch and breakfast in the buffet. But this cruise was interesting because about half of the guests were from China, from mainland China. And the Chinese, because they tend to travel in big families, tend to prefer the buffet restaurant. So the buffet restaurant actually on this cruise was actually more full than the dining room because people liked to be able to choose when they ate and what they ate. But yeah, so obviously this is the dessert. Here's your plating for the formal dining room. And so this dining room on the ship, actually there's three levels. So there's one, two, three. And each one has different maitre d's, different sets of servers. And this is where you get the formal three-course. These are my meals. They're also all on Instagram if you want to look. So for the food and beverages, so you look over here on the table, that's what you're seeing here. So you've got the silver service set up, multiple spoons and all of that. Glasses, the water glasses, all that. So your teacher's correct. That is how you do it. These pictures are also from the buffet. And this picture is just one of the things that a lot of cruise ships now have is called chef's table, which is an extra. It's a degustation, basically. That is a special meal prepared by the chef for people who pay $100, and it has multiple courses. So usually there's one or two of those. Yes, pay extra money to have that experience. Okay, recycling. It doesn't sound like fun, but when you're on a cruise ship, where does the garbage go? You can't throw it overboard. It has to be recycled. So recycling, nowadays the environment is really important, obviously. So cruise ships, it's bad PR for cruise ships to be found to not be environmentally friendly. So recycling is really important because, if you think about how much plastic, paper, all of this that, 2,000, 3,000 people generate in a day, it has to go somewhere. It's a ship. It's filled the ocean. It has to go somewhere. So they're on board these ships. There's somebody whose job it is to come up with ways to store and recycle